Welcome to Enjoy Northwoods. Yeah, we're back on the creek and we're back on that deposit, and it's probably going to be our last time here until January. Bow season's coming and we don't want to be screwing around out here with messing up the hunter's harvest. So we're going to put in a day and see what we get. And anyways, I'm here with my friend Dan, and we're going to see how much gold we can get. So stay tuned. We got a couple sluices set up. Following a bigger one. We're waiting for the river to raise. Show you where we're digging. We pretty much dug this whole way here. Dan's on the shovel, and this is that boulder we stopped at. My actual biggest amount of gold I've ever got was right about where that shovel is. That was last winter, but that was right behind this boulder. So we're hoping to do pretty good today. We're gonna see what we get, but we're gonna continue on and work down the edge of this. Through the winter, I poked along periodically when I was trying to find everything. So there is some spots that I've already hit, but probably nothing more than a 5-gallon bucket or so. So we're gonna continue on and hopefully we get some. Dug a little bit right here, and we did two. Dan dug about a full bucket and I got about a 3/4 bucket. We got two little sluices going, still waiting for her to fill, but we're running it. We'll see what we get. Still got it running. Did one clean out. And working on another one. Easier. Thank you. There's a little, used to be my concentrate clean out sleeves. And I threw a couple cutoffs of the Gold Hog mother load mat on it. And I put these detachable little fins on it. It's changing really well. It's pretty easy. And I fed it pretty heavy too, so pretty good test. Dan's doing another clean out. We ran a couple more buckets. And I'm gonna clean this one out and see how it goes. And here's that little, this used to be my concentrate sluice, like I said. I put these little detachable fins in just a little bracket. And that seemed to work out pretty good. Another nice garnet. This thing is just loaded in garnets. Look at them all. Look at that baby. That's a real good one. There's another one up here too. One more.
All in all, pretty good day. How many buckets have we run? Six or eight buckets, mostly full. Three clean outs, we're on our third clean out, so see lots of garnets, a little bit of gold, but we'll see when we get back and go through all the concentrates. But all in all, pretty good day.
All right, we are packed up. We'll hike out of here. Let me show you what we dug. We kind of dug right on this tailing section here. Just showing up. But rounding the bend, and this is kind of the towards the back of the deposit. So we hugged the bank and we dug here. So we're heading out. Thanks, Dan, for coming along. Appreciate it. And we're going to hike back.
All right, guys. Well, it is 2 weeks later, and we made it. We're going to go through those concentrates that we got. Dan's probably anxiously waiting. We got quite a bit to go through, so let me get this baby set up, and we'll get at her.
Yeah, I wanted to show you something real quick. I don't know how many of you guys use pack frame. These are external frames. Grew up using these things, absolutely love them. But what I want to show you is how much gear you can get on one of these. This is what I carried out when me and Dan went out. And it's just my day bag that just hooks to the back. Pardon me for a minute. But anyways, that has my pans, snuffer bottles, trowels, lunch, everything like that that we're going to carry. And then I got my shovel, and believe it or not, there's three sluices on this. So, this little one, it just slides in. This little one that we just took out to try. My shovel. And then, all right, well, this is what I wanted to show you. I couldn't do it one-handed, but this is what was packed on my frame. We have three sluices, a shovel, and then a pack full of all the necessities, all on the frame, and that's how I carry the majority of my stuff. You can pack a lot, and not just mining stuff, but all kinds of different things. And it gave me an idea. So what I'm going to do is for our 500th subscriber, I'm going to get a brand new frame, and we're going to get a brand new day pack, a couple pans, and we're going to build a little adventure prospecting pack, and that'll be for our 500 sub giveaway. So that's going to be fun. Who knows what it's going to end up with, but I know it'll end up with a bunch of goodies. So we're going to get started on that next, so that's pretty exciting. So anyways, let me get this set up, and we'll get back at it. This is what we ended up with. Nice Tupperware filled. Got some black sand in it. We've seen it had some garnets. Plus we got what's in this bucket, which is probably almost the same, if not the same, as what we got there. So we got quite a bit to go through. So I'm going to take my time a little bit. We are going to break this down, get the bigs out of it, and I'm going to go through the bigs. Because this spot, we have been getting a little bit bigger gold on occasion. So I'm going to check this, plus try to get as many garnets as I can. And we're going to give this cleanup to Dan. So let's hope we get a bunch. All right, guys, this is what we ended up with. A pretty big pile of classified concentrates. We classified her down with our flower gold kitchen strainer. Here's the bigs I get to go through. So I am gonna go through the bigs first, and then we are probably gonna grab a cocktail for this one because this is gonna be a while. So let me get her going.
Seen a couple pieces showing up. Looks like we're running pretty good. I'm gonna keep going. Keep shoveling her in.
I don't think it shows up with this glare, but I just love how this mat works, how it just rumbles and tumbles. It does do a pretty good job. And we are seeing gold. Yeah, look at her working. Looks like she's working just about perfect. Staying about half full, and she's a rocking. All right, guys, this is, we got her all set and done. This is what we ended up with. We got a few nice garnets, and we got some gold. I was hoping a little better. But overall, not too bad. We got 5 or 6 decent pieces. No big pieces. A couple little wiry pieces. But all in all, I'd say some over 100 pieces, definitely well under 200 pieces. So there you go, Dan. This is what you get here in Michigan. So on a good day, I might add.
All right, guys, that's a wrap. We had an awesome day today. We got some gold, a little over 100 pieces. We moved quite a bit of dirt. We worked the tailing end of a deposit I've been working. So all in all, it was a great day. Glad my buddy was able to come out and see what it's about. He took me to Alaska. He's a longtime Alaska resident, and he took me to some of his secret spots fishing. We just got back on a fishing trip, and we have a time of our life. It was the best fishing I've ever had. Beautiful scenery. We did all kinds of little adventures. We did a road trip, hit the ocean, fished all night long. Got to see the midnight sun in Alaska, fished through that. More waterfalls than I can note even say, but an awesome time, so I was glad to repay it. It was mainly a fishing trip. I did bring a couple pans. We did a little panning around. We found gold, like to say, in every pan. A couple pans we got, we only had a speck or two, but it was still gold. The average was 20 to 30 pieces. We hit three different rivers, just poking around. Like I said, we didn't really go looking for gold, but we found gold everywhere we looked. The best thing was the main place we stayed, we got 100 pieces per pan right next to our tent. So freaking awesome. He never really did any gold mining the whole time he lived out there. So this was kind of new to him. And he was pleasantly shocked, especially when we were getting 100 pieces per pan. Now that we're back and I took him out, now we can see what I'm talking about. It was, we worked all day for our 100 pieces, or I rinsed off a pan right next to our tent. So he didn't know how good he had it right under his feet the whole time he lived there. So that was pretty awesome. We're definitely going back. I can't get it out of my mind now. Definitely want to be prepared and go make a run at it. So that's in the making. So stay tuned on that. Also got a video coming out on our trip, putting something together, been a little bit hard getting it out. It's been pretty busy, so look for that. That ought to be a pretty nice video. Also, remember, I'm building that pack to give away for our 500 subscriber. Ordered the frame already. Got a pack. Haven't chose the one I'm going to get, but we're going to get that. We're going to make an awesome little package to give away. The survival stuff, the pack, and everything. We're going to add some goodies. It's right up my alley, so that ought to be interesting. I hope you guys really like that. So if you like the video, hit like, subscribe, so you got a chance to win this pack. And leave me a like, leave me a comment. Let me know what you guys think. So another beautiful day in the Michigan neighborhood. So till our next adventure, I'll see you guys around.
Follow the sun, and which way the wind blows. This day is done. Breathe, breathe in the air. Set your intentions.